content about my journey on the Chinese landscape painting. So firstly, I mapped out my ideas and mapped out some of my inspirations, as well as understood the deeper history of Chinese painting via a mind mapping website called Miro. And like, for example, some of these mind maps allowed me to find out the traits of Chinese paintings, and which allowed me to better replicate some of these Chinese paintings. Additionally, it also allowed me to make some of a mood board in order to know what kind of items I want in my painting, and to better plan out my painting in order to fit the theme of the poem which I had chosen. And the poem I had chosen in my artwork is a poem that somewhat celebrates the Chinese New Year. So it starts with 爆竹声中一岁雨一岁除春风送暖入土土树 天门万户同同日总把新桃换旧符, which basically means that once the firecracker goes off, like explodes, it signals the start of a new year. And then it's basically like telling about how in the morning of the first day of the new year, the sun shines brightly, and many people replace the old charms hung on the shrines to the new wooden charms for the new year. And so I decided to draw a scenery that somewhat represents it, I think. And so this scenery is basically a village on a mountain. Basically the sun is like high up and shining on the village, basically like a new year. And then like on some of the villages, I drew some like new year decorations, which I think they would have used back in that era. And then I think it would better signal the message of the poem. And I also drew it such that the mountains were like, there were like a lot of mountains at the back, as I wanted to show that this was like somewhat of an isolated village rather than a large bustling city. And many of the techniques I used are stuff that like I just learned on the journey, because I never touched this program before. And I think it was a very interesting experience, because it was actually quite realistic, and the way the water worked was also somewhat intuitive because of how realistic it was and how close it was to normal watercolour. And I also used a lot of inspiration from other people's traditional Chinese painting in order to make it look more